Morning, Sunday 10th of June. Jamie's just here making a little dam, I can see. By the stream here. This is the sound I've looked forward to hearing again. Sound of nature. Really nice. And now we're just camping here behind this ski resort hotel here. We'll just have a breakfast now on the carpet in the sun. That's always nice as well. Even though we're 2,000 meters up in the mountains, it's still nice and sunny and nice and warm today. So, yeah. So we'll have our breakfast now and then we'll pack away and head towards cars. Back on the road. It's a ski resort behind us there. It's a hotel we just camped behind. That was good. Really nice place. We're heading for cars today.
Your neck's rolling again there. Hurting them, is that?
Yeah, a bit stiff to start.
Every time we are starting, every time I'm hurting in my legs, it's very horrible. But yes, that is the thing you need to learn on a bike when you start your bike.
It's we had a long day the day before. Yeah. Legs are tired to start off with. And they warm up and then away we go again. So the ski lift's there. You can expect to see find a place like this up here. Now we're up at 2,000 metres. It's pretty flat here now. Okay, 19 to Salim and 50 to Cars. Now we can see where we're biking for a good part of today. Extremely flat plains up here. Oh, so we get some lunch here in Salim. I'll pick up some bread from a baker if we can find one. But the kind of town where life hasn't changed for many years. Just bought some two pieces of bread in this shop behind me. Well, baker. Another one of those traditional breakers with a real fire going. Fire oven. So, okay, let's go on the road to cars. I've just turned up here in Mini Gorima. Looks like a service station that once upon a time used to look quite nice. Looks like everything in this area used to be nice once. It's just not maintained at all. It's a shame. All this is just run down. Oh yeah, look how nice that is. Wow. Imagine turning up here when this was all in action, having a cup of tea in there. We'll sit here and have our lunch now. This table and chairs just have seen better days, but at least this side is working, so we can sit on there to enjoy the nice bread. It all seems to be the same shape of bread, this part of Turkey. Nice to pick up a fresh, warm loaf in the morning and eat it for lunch. I've got a new friend once again. Just moved under the cover here. Raining a bit.
Yeah. Now the little doggy are coming.
Looking after you, you're just here on your own in this closed down petrol station in the door.
Yeah. Interesting though. Even though Turkey is a very big country, especially to cross on a bike, but even though every day has been different in some kind of way. Well, yesterday we were in a valley, a beautiful valley, and mountains and a mountain to climb. Today it's just open flat plains up on the steppe here. Quite interesting. Every day changes. Always puts a smile on your face when you see downhill like this, stretching out into the distance.
Hello. First sight of cars in the distance there. We're just talking about we'll find a hotel there tonight, have some dinner, then carry on towards Georgia tomorrow. We're getting close to cars. On the first leg of the tour down to Athens, and then the second half just in one single country, Turkey. Amazing how big Turkey is, especially when you cycle from west to east. Now we're getting close. Kars is the last town we'll stay in before we get to the border, or the last real big town. Kept to the original plan, then we would have been approaching the border of Iran now, around about this time, if I'd have managed to have gotten a visa that allowed me to cycle freely there. But that's the reason why we're taking these extra little tours to Georgia and Armenia, just because there was a delay on getting my letter of invitation, so that's why we're going to Yerevan to pick that up. So that means we'll spend 2 weeks more just cycling in Armenia, and then we'll enter Iran via the south of Armenia, on the border between Iran and Armenia there. So, 85,000 people, it's an altitude of 1,700 meters, it's just cars. Modern apartment blocks on the outskirts here. See what the centre of the city looks like.
This is so funny. Now we come to Kars. Haven't been here very long, but the town seems very different to Erzurum, where everything was almost closed in the daytime. And here we just found a western coffee bar, really, with
cheesecake.
Cheesecake.
Long time we've seen anything cheesecake. That looks like cheesecake.
And chocolate cake.
Chocolate cake.
Cappuccino with bubbles on the tongue.
Yeah, cappuccino with bubbles on. Very strange, and it's open here in the middle of afternoon. Yeah. Yeah, everything seems to be open compared to the restaurant when everything was closed.
Yeah.
Very strange, it's
have
only 200
kilometers away. Yeah. 2.5 days biking and now we're here. Pretty close to the border now.
Yes.
Okay, it might be a fancy coffee shop here, but there's just a van with sheep just came by. You don't see that in any high street in England or Denmark, unless you're living in Wales maybe. But that was funny. It's quite nice.
Area of cars here, the church there, or mosque there.
We'll find a hotel now and see if we can have a look around the town a bit later, maybe get something to eat. It's when you're on a bike, you don't need to buy fuel for your car, but you need fuel for yourself, and that's food, so I have to spend some money on that.
So now we are using the maybe 600 kronas to the diesel to our car, but now we are using that cake and our energy.
Yeah, you can buy a lot of food here for 600 kroner, the cost of one tank of fuel in Denmark. Like a Christmas tree there. All ready to go for Christmas time. Okay, another nice room here. This will be our last hotel here in Turkey. So, I think after here, let's have a look at the window. Yeah, a bad place really. So we'll spend the night here, and we got 1.5 days biking until the border.
Yeah, it's so about 100 kilometers. We'll check the map on the computer later and see if it's up or down.
Probably a bit of problem.
Hopefully, like
all the way to Georgia. Yeah, we'll see later. So yep, that's it. Our last hotel, and we'll be heading to the border. We'll have a look around in the town, I think, later, see what it looks like here. No idea yet, but sure we'll find out. So, okay, we'll see you in the town, maybe. Okay, it's time for a walk around Kars now.
see what it looks like here. Oh, nice and clean again. Have a little look at cats. You can see up on the hill there, that's Carr's Castle. Here, but looks like the town's all getting ready for to break the fasting for today and start eating their evening dinner. I see all the little tea shops who just walk by there getting ready with the low stools and the low tables that they have here with carpets on. We have a nice view of the castle behind. Also a nice large mosque here. Seems to be the men are waiting in a queue over there. And the women are waiting in a queue for something here, maybe. I'm not sure what's happening. Okay, we just asked the man by the sign there what's happening. He says that it is they're breaking the today's fast now, where they can wait in a queue there and they can get some food. Actually, the food is free, and when they've eaten, they pray in the mosque there. So I never know what's happening here. That was interesting. You just notice they're bringing blankets and they sit on and bring their food now, you can see. And they eat their evening meal here. Interesting. So again, all the small tables here are ready for the chai and tea after the dinner, evening dinner. Probably one of the last times we'll be able to see this, because soon we'll be in Georgia. Leaving a Muslim country, we'll be entering Georgia and Armenia, two Christian countries, so probably the last time we experience this in Turkey. So we'll be waiting until we get to Iran, and we'll probably see something similar maybe. We'll have to see what that's like. This is the kind of table and chairs we have to get when we get home. Tiny, but they're really nice to sit on and drink tea on.
Okay, now we are sitting in the western, and the same we have tried many times. All the things are on the table in the first room, so everything is set up to us.
In these Turkish restaurants, you have to time it right. 7:30, everybody just... everybody comes at the same time. So we have to quickly get a table before it's too late. This is such a nice place.
How the restaurant looked like after everyone had eaten.
Well, we're the last ones here again.
Yeah, only one family over there.
Okay. Yes. So, yes. Hey, very quickly here for some reason. I don't know why. Well, it's a very fine hotel here. It's almost quite funny because this is the way the tap is fitted. Well, actually not fitted. Still works okay even though it's
like this.
It works. What more do you need?
So that was basically it from Kars. One evening here. That was quite nice. We'll look around the town. This will be the last real town we visit in Turkey. So tomorrow will be heading towards the border. We won't get all the way to the border, but we'll be pretty close to it, so should be camping by a lake, I think, tomorrow. And then it'll be Tuesday. We should cross the border to Georgia, and that will be the end of Turkey. So, okay, see you tomorrow.